Welcome back in, everyone, to EA Sports coverage of the NFL. It's the Falcons in possession of... ...the football as we rejoin the action in the first quarter.
Ready! Back 25!
They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. Here's Ryan. Got his man, that's the Pro Bowler, Julio Jones. 30, 10, touchdown, Falcons. Julio Jones, 66 yards, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Well, if they didn't get the wake-up call before the game, they got it right now. Two plays already in the end zone.
I think of it in boxing terms because... whether it's a big shot with your first one or a probing one, a little bit of a jab, the second one was the payoff. That was the big one that landed. 1-2, end zone.
On for the extra point, Giorgio Tavecchio. Flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And that'll be incomplete. I'm going to go out on a limb and say that you don't like that call on the opening drive of the game.
It's a very strong limb that you're out on right now. Okay, and look, the game between college and the NFL continues to creep closer, but that is truly... a college play, not an NFL play. Because you'd snap the ball from the 3-yard line there, whether it's going for one or going for two. So it makes sense to try it that way to maybe fake it. In this case, from the 15, makes zero sense.
And now your lead's just 6-0 instead of 7-0. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Here's Nick Chubb, former prep and collegiate star here in this state at Georgia. Up from his linebacker spot, Deion Jones making the play.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. Mayfield hands it off to Chubb. It's a 4-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with 3rd and 5.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Mayfield from the gun on 3rd down. And he's got his man. That's Landry. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 13 yards to pick up there. Good for a Cleveland first.
But we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered. But how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I think we'll hear about that from him soon.
That one first down. He's going to sneak it. 2 yards the gain on the keeper, and it's second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Here's a four-receiver look now. Three of those guys out to the right side on second and eight. Mayfield to throw it this time. He's got Njoku, his big tight end. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons 19.
Press coverage on the outside, and for defenders, that's the ultimate risk-reward. If you take the risk, can you reward yourself by keeping them on the line of scrimmage? But no, not on that one. Got the step on him. Now it's just a matter of laying the ball out there for him to go get it.
And am I seeing this correctly? They brought out the field goal team here on first down. Oh, look at this. A flip to the kicker. He's going to try to run for it. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. That's going to go as a loss of six, and it'll set him back for second down. So go ahead and mark that down as one of the most bizarre first down calls in the history of the National Football League. A fake. And it backfires.
But we've seen a lot
on
of
first down.
Yeah, you're right. And we've seen a lot of innovation throughout the years in the NFL. I mean, we've gone from the single wing to the T formation to shotgun, right? Running spread, running shoot, you name it, right?
To first down field goal.
First down field goal fakes. I think that's an innovation that will not catch on. It's funny, throughout the time that we've been together, when we talk with running backs about the ability to catch the ball, their eyes light up when they talk about open field and having one-on-one matchups, don't they?
Yeah, they do. And that's the reason why. What we just saw, shedding those tackles, and that's what they're used to doing.
It is, and it starts at the beginning of the play, one-on-one matchup if someone's trying to cover them. But they also like those one-on-ones downfield after the catch when they're running with the ball. They think they're going to win those, too.
So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears trying to go for it on fourth.
Encroachment defense.
A free 5 yards as the defense jumps.
I know it's an anticipation game for them, but it's also a reaction game, and they reacted poorly on that one.
And no field goal try here from the red zone. Offense out there. They'll go for it on fourth. They'll run for it. Chubb. And he has the first down before he's tackled at the five. So give him the first down. First and goal after a pickup of four. And the decision to go for it pays off. First and goal and a chance to get that initial touchdown right back. They'll run with Chubb, and the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
So he got three of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. He'll get five out of the keeper, but now it's third down.
Some good strong running right there. Some power and some explosiveness just about got him into the end zone.
Well, they've gotten it down to the three, but now this is third and goal. Throwing, Mayfield. And he's got it. The completion there winds up a wash, and it'll bring up fourth down.
They dialed up the blitz on third down, and your worry as a defense that they can hit you with a big play in that situation. Instead, the blitz pays off, able to rally to the football and make the play.
They converted once earlier on this opening drive, but now comes a big test. Fourth and goal. Now Mayfield on fourth down. Njoku pulls this one in. He's got it for a Cleveland touchdown. A 3-yard touchdown pass as his guys can now take the lead with the extra point. Big fourth down conversion for the score and the defense. That is a tough pill to swallow.
Big time for them. How about them just deciding to go for it on fourth down? And, forget the field goal, because that looked like an easy 3 points. Yeah, you might have had a defensive breakdown in there, but they pressed the issue and found a way to get it into the end zone. Give them big credit for that.
So up comes Mayfield as his guys will go for two. And now they'll take a knee here. And my partner now is speechless, and so am I.
I feel like we're going to see more and more of this continue to flow into the NFL game, and that is the quarterback run game. Not successful here going for two, but it's not something that people shy away from totally anymore either.
In particular, do you think more so around the goal line?
I think so. Anytime it's short yardage, anytime you can go ahead and keep the ball in the hands of the quarterback who's athletic, you go ahead and do that rather than risk a handoff or a pitch.
They just couldn't get it done there, though. 2-point try fails. So back even at six apiece as the kick's away. That's fielded in the end zone. Still going. And he's going to be taken down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. These two teams all tied after one. About set to begin their next drive. The Falcons offense at the line. Ryan now off the bootleg. And this one caught along the sideline, but they say already out of bounds. Now the throw didn't give him a chance to turn it upfield, and that brings up second down.
By the way, I got to apologize because I just realized for about the last four or five plays, I'm eking over into your territory up here in the booth. My bad. I'm going to get back over to my spot.
Yeah, we're not talking about our on-air commentary. I mean, what is all this extra paper? I mean, this is unusual for you.
My bad.
Normally, you run a really tight ship. What's going on here?
Just like that incomplete pass, I'm going to try to tighten things up here for this next play.
Now, a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they've managed to get it done.
The field position game, such an overlooked facet, Charles, of an NFL game, but this offense, they're going to be pinned back. What an ideal punt.
An ideal punt, and it leads to that term complementary football, because them doing that puts their defense in a great spot, doesn't it? Gives them a chance. If they want to be aggressive, try and maybe get a safety out of this whole thing, it puts them in that position.
The Browns drive about to get started, and they will start this drive with just terrible field position, backed up inside their own five.
But we have seen teams be bold here and take shots, right? Sometimes you go max protection, make it a one receiver route, and take your shot downfield and see what happens. And occasionally, we've seen success occur.
They start on the ground with Nick Chubb, weaving through traffic, and now he's free. He's at the 50. He's at the 30, past the 20, and all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. Nick Chubb, 96 yards, and the Browns have taken the lead. And with that carry, he's already over 100 yards here in the first half.
And, partner, you know exactly what he's saying to his teammates right now, right? Especially to the play caller.
Give me the ball.
Again and again,
again.
It's not that heavy, sir. I'll take it.
So up comes Mayfield as his guys will go for two. Mayfield to throw it. And it's incomplete. But a flag is down here, so hang on. Let's see what we've got. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Joseph now to kick this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. Trucks over him. And he'll probably wish he'd reconsidered here. It will cost him 10 yards as he's down at the 15.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Ryan will bring the Falcons up now, first and 10 at their own 15. Now Ryan, under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Jannard Avery coming in hard there on the blitz, and he gets him 7 yards behind the line of scrimmage. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
Now, following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Now it's Ryan. He's going to float this over the middle deep. Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Morgan Burnett, and they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line.
Oh, man, Brandon, not a real good throw that time. It looked like he tried to put a little too much air under this one, and it turned into a floater. And defensively, this is a dream. He could have fair caught that one. That was way too easy.
Heading out is the Cleveland offense now as they get set to take over here.
It away, and it falls down incomplete. The Pro Bowler Odell Beckham, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
The Browns on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and 11. A run for Nick Chubb. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. That'll move the sticks for the Browns, a gain of 12.
Now this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They run again on first down, Chubb. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves pieces like they were able to exploit right there.
The first down run got five. Here's second and five. Chubb. And an alley to run. A second time. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Just what the Browns needed there. Good for a gain of 17.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Him just inside the 10 to the 9, but no further. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
They go with Chubb on second down. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. That's a big loss of three, and it brings up third down.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
Mayfield. And this is caught. Touchdown, Cleveland. To make the grab. And the Browns are going to tack on to their advantage. That's why you've got your star out there. Throw the ball to him. They did.
That's simply saying we don't care what coverage you put out there. He's so good, we're going there with the football anyway, and there's not a thing you can do about it.
Inside the red zone, they go to him. He gets it done. So up comes Mayfield as his guys will go for two.
Hey, pick your game up.
Here's Chubb to try to run it in. And he will get into the end zone to extend the lead by two more. So they kept it on the ground, got it into the end zone. But Charles, sometimes you probably see teams treat a two-point conversion differently than if it was first and goal from the two, or I should say third and goal from the two.
I agree with you totally on that. A lot of teams treat it as if they have farther to go and shy away from running the football. I think this is a great spot to do it because most teams play you for the pass. Go ahead and run and let your linemen surge and fire out.
Joseph now to kick this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line.
We got this.
Second quarter action, 1:56 remaining. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. They go play action here on first down. He completes it to Jones. And he'll have it past midfield, almost to the 40 before being taken down. 25 yards that time. Now a play fake here on first down. And it's hauled in by Austin Hooper. That'll wind up a gain of 27 on the catch and run.
It's so important to tackle well against these guys, but you and I both know that's easier said than done when the guy you're trying to tackle looks like this guy.
And it's usually going to take more than one man to get him down, and it did right there. Carry, despite the extra effort, will be stopped short of the 10. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Here's a 2nd and 7. And he's got his star receiver. It's Jones for the Falcon touchdown. Julio Jones with his 2nd touchdown here in this first half, as his guys are back within a single score.
I think everyone in the league talks about finishing, don't they? Doesn't matter whether it's a quarter, a half, a game, a series, whatever. But they're finishing the first half in fine style, putting that one in the end zone.
They did, and they didn't leave much time on the clock either. Well done. Dan Quinn's told his offense, let's try and get 2 more. Now it's Ryan. And he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line. So now, Charles, 2 touchdowns, 2 tries at 2-point conversions, and both fail.
And you want to say, let's go ahead and run the kicker out there from now on. But the problem is you're chasing points at this stage. So now you've got to dial up more 2-point conversions and hope you're successful from here on out.
Boy, they're down only 1 score, still first half, but they're going to line up for the onside kick. And the Browns are able to cover this one up. Let's go, boy, And heading back out there now, the Falcons defense here. And despite being down on the scoreboard, this unit, they've had some big-time hits.
Sort of like us at practice the other day. I saw you take a running start at that blocking sled. You took it down.
Bounced off like a rubber band.
No, not at all, but you're exactly right. They are doing their job, but they want to add takeaways to it. You need to have more of those to go along with the big hits we're seeing.
By the way, when I tried that and I bounced back, I noticed that you laughed with everyone else. You didn't try to get in my corner.
No. Someone had just told me a joke on the other side. Right, I missed that. Right. Totally missed it.
The first down carry here for Johnson. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Back to the ground. This time it's Chubb. And he'll go down at the 28. That one, a first down pickup of 8. On the carry, it's Chubb. Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of 4. So we have reached halftime here in what's an 8-point game. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This game's had a little bit of everything thus far, and certainly plenty to look forward to, as the teams are right back out there for the second half. So we'll get right back out there as well, as we'll turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A 1-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. The Browns are going to get the second half kickoff, and they've got this lead as well as we are back and underway. That'll be taken in the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. Here's the Browns offense now getting set to start off this third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense if that fell harmlessly to the ground. That's good for a Cleveland first down, an 11-yard pickup. They run. Chubb shrugs off another. Look at this, middle of the field, a breakaway. And all the way in, touchdown, Cleveland. Nick Chubb, his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Browns are going to tack on to their advantage. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit, get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, you know, the second half, no matter what, whether it's first 5 minutes, first 3, whatever, this was a big score to start the second half.
So up comes Mayfield as his guys will go for two. Here's Chubb to try to run it in. And he is into the end zone again. So get him some oxygen. He scores on the long run and then punches in the two-point conversion for good measure. Joseph now to kick this one away. And a short kick, taking it about the 16. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. And now let's discuss Julio Jones. And I know that they double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it? Right. Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
Ryan and the Falcons now come up first and 10 at their own 27. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by the linebacker, Joe Schobert. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27.
Ah, Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball. And I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
Cleveland geared up to take the field. Now, these guys hardly got a chance to catch their breath after the quick turnover, but I doubt they're complaining much.
Especially with the field position they get to start with, I wouldn't be complaining either. I'd want to get right back out there and get after them because now you have an opportunity to make a big play. I'd say let's be aggressive and go after him.
On the ground, it's Chubb. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8.
But no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Three receivers head out right, one to the left on 2nd and 3. To throw, Mayfield. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. David Njoku, a beast in the red zone with his 2nd touchdown of the game. And the forced turnover on defense leads to 6 points.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors, but that's his 2nd touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Greg Joseph on for the extra point. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And it's caught. And he gets in. But no one was expecting a fake there, but they add 2 more onto their lead.
Partner, they're up big. They snapped the ball from the 15 for a regular PAT. Yet they fake it and get it. Is the kicker's leg tired? What's going on here?
I don't know, but defensively, now with this deficit, now you add 2 more onto that. They fake the PAT. That stings a little.
It definitely stings, and I know the guys that I play.